If you bottle down human motives to two, zero and one binary type motives, will have either love or fear. Men who are trying to control women, they often work out of fear, and this is a sign of an undeveloped ego consciousness. When you develop your ego consciousness and see the world objectively as it is, yeah, you can really understand that a woman would like a man who knows who he is, who is respectful to her, who is respectful to who he is, and doesn't take shit. Yo, yo, guys, how are you doing? Ari, Lift Heavy Grow Beards here. Today I want to talk about why controlling your woman will get you nowhere. This is true in regards to dating, and this is true in regards to a relationship. If you try to control your woman will walk away from you. I'll try to explain this in archetypical standards and how archetypes affects our behavior, and I'll also try to give you an explanation through everyday life to make it kind of simple for you. Essentially, in the beginning, when you meet a woman, women find controlling men attractive. This is because they display strength, they display power, they display character, and they think that a man who's showing power will be independent. In reality, men who are trying to control women, they often work out of fear, and this is a sign of an undeveloped ego consciousness. If you bottle down human motives to two, zero and one binary type motives, will have either love or fear. Okay, the opposite of love is actually fear. It is not hate. If you act from fear, you're by necessity not acting out of love. For example, if you're single and you're sending her a little question mark to see if she read your message, or she didn't answer your message, so you're calling to kind of gently remind her, or you know, if you're just calling just to check in on her to see what she's doing, you're asking who she's out with to make sure she's only out with girlfriends and not with male friends. You want to see that there's no other suitors in the picture. When you're in a relationship, an example for acting out of fear and trying to control your woman is looking through her messages to make sure she isn't cheating on you. Again, stalking on her social to see who commented on her bikini pictures. Needing to know where she is, who she's with all the time. If you hear a man's voice in the background when you talk on the phone, you have to ask, ooh, who's that? Is he hitting on you? What's going on there? Trying to get her to censor what she wears. If she wears something a little bit too showy and go like, hey, why are you doing that? People will hit on you. Getting angry if people hit on her. If every time she's going away from you, or have a jealousy tantrum or an anger tantrum. This is the little boy who cries when he loses his mommy in a crowded place. This is the little boy who is angry that his candy is being taken away from him. These are signs of an immature male character. Contrary to a guy who says, hey, you can date whoever you want. I know I'm the best. It's all good. You can date, you can see, you can wander around. In the end, you'll come back. These are underlying structures of consciousness that can interfere with a relationship and can cause a woman to go, ugh. The most important thing is that you need to understand that you cannot throw this type of emotional baggage on your woman. If you have a problem, if you're insecure and you're afraid that your woman's going to leave you, or that she's going to find something better, or that she's going to cheat on you, or whatever, these are signs that you need to go inwards and ask, what is the problem with me? Why do I think like that, right? And try to find the traumas or the causes that makes you feel so insecure and believe that you are not a catch. Think of the great archetypical myth of Shiva and Shakti. I repeat this myth all the time. Shiva, the god of destruction, the representative of the divine masculine, he sits in the sky and meditates. In other words, he's doing what he needs to do, what his purpose is about, meditating, right? Because he is consciousness, he is ideas, this is all masculine traits. Consciousness is masculine. Shakti, the goddess of femininity, creativity, playfulness, she sees him meditate, and that causes Shakti to want his attention. So Shakti dresses up like a fly, tries to annoy Shiva during his meditation. Shiva never leaves his meditation, and that only causes Shakti to try harder and be interested more in Shiva. This is the equivalent of a man trying to go on his purpose and is encountering the world and is encountering the trouble of the world. I'm not saying that women is trouble. I'm just saying that women will try to move you out of your purpose with play, with trying to get your attention, with attitude. And this is exactly what the dynamic of the masculine and the feminine is. When you are chasing after your woman, and the chasing can also be trying to keep her, this means that you're coming out of your own purpose and making your purpose about the woman. A woman will never feel comfortable when there is a man trying to control her. A woman will feel comfortable when her man knows her, knows his purpose, knows his value, knows his calling, knows his rarity, knows that he's a rare breed, and is confident about that. And women will be attracted to that. There is no case in real life that chasing a woman helps or brings you towards being closer to the woman. In Hollywood movies, we always see that man is doing something stupid, then the woman shies away from the guy, and then the guy does a stupid romantic gesture that makes the woman understand that, oh, he's the one for me, blah, blah, blah. That just does not happen. These scripts are written by women and by beta males, people who don't understand the nature of relationships. Hollywood movies embody, again, archetypes and types of myth and stories that don't relate to the actual world. Take, for example, Hollywood's most perfect beta male, Ross Geller from Friends. Ross is a feminine, whiny, nerdy, immature good guy who has a crush on Rachel for literally 20 years. Although throughout the series, he always acts like a second-class male, we learn that if he only chases enough and does really, really sweet things, the girl will end up his. I'm gonna make a separate video on Ross Geller's beta male energies and how that would actually amount to nothing in the real world, but let's just agree that Hollywood just shows us different type of males that we just don't want to be. For example, with Ross, you see the person who chases and just does a stupid romantic gesture that causes the girl to win his heart. That just doesn't really happen. So don't chase and don't do any stupid romantic shit to make the girl think you like her. So, three things you can do to kind of develop into that direction. The first thing is you need to know that you are a catch. Really know it. That means that even if the woman chooses to let you go, she was not the right one for you and another bus is coming in about 15 minutes. Okay? If you think that you are not a catch, if you think that this woman is above you, if you think that the one slip up that you'll do, she will discover the real you and then she will leave you, this is not a good place to start with, okay? This is a place of fear and not of love. And if you're not loving towards yourself, you cannot be loving towards a woman. Women will sense that insecurity and will shy away from it right away. Stuff like the myth of the one is an archetypical myth. An archetypical myth that comes from ancient stories about the one thing or the one God or the one truth or anything like that, that there is only one path towards a certain thing, okay? The original, I think that the original archetypical story is that there is only one way to heaven, right? There is only one way to meet God. We kind of imitate that throughout the culture, that we think that there's only one way to skin a cat, where actually there's multiple ways to skin a cat. In other words, there's multiple women for you out there that will be amazing for you. So essentially, if you believe that there is this one girl for you and that's it, you're living through this archetype of the one thing, the one ring, the one truth, the one God, and you're not living the world as it is for real. Okay, if you live the objective world, you will know there are millions of fish out there in the sea. Out of those million, let's say that 10 of them are perfect for you. Remember that no matter what you want to do, no matter what your instinct tells you, chasing a woman will get you nowhere, nowhere, ever. For all of that, I've written a dating pocketbook. This is a small book that will just give you the gist of what you need to do when dating. That will Increase the polarity between the masculine and the feminine will allow you to play the masculine role and in turn allow the woman to get comfortable in her own feminine role and open up to you. I got this ebook for you for free. All you need to do is hit the link in the description and you can get that ebook for free. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. It helps me a lot in promoting the channel. Don't forget, I'm here for you every week with content about how to be a beast at the gym, how to have better relationship with yourself, how to have better relationship with women, how to understand your girlfriend, how to get a girlfriend, psychology, human relationships, and a whole bunch of other useful stuff that I think that you might find beneficial. If this video helped you, please send it to your friends. Until then, I'll talk to you soon.